We're going to talk first a little bit, which what we call actually a Dhamma talk. We're going to talk a little bit about what Metta actually means, Metta loving kindness, what that actually means. But Metta, it's important to realize that it is in spite of yourself. That means you yourself, with whatever you are right now, are not in between that energy. The energy comes from you, but has got nothing to do with your personal self.
Metta
Probably comparable to the love that a mother has for her child, which is without any reason sometimes. A child can be really naughty, and we might think that's a horrible child, whereas in the eyes of the mother, it's a beautiful child, it's always okay. But in that sense, you should transform that to every sentient being.
而且这个爱,
Metta is built up of four elements, actually. And to truly, become in that energy, all these elements have to be available within your heart chakra. So it's actually Metta, which is loving kindness or universal love.
Metta 它也是一种宇宙性的一种大爱。Karuna,
which is compassion. Compassion means that when you see somebody, you feel what they are feeling. That's compassion.
任何你对人类，你可以感受到那个共情，那就是属于这个慈悲。
The next step is mudita, which is sympathetic joy, and that actually means that you can put yourself completely in the place of the other, as if you are the other.
第二个可以说是一种同情心或同理心。
And of course, we always save the hardest one for last, which is upeka, and that's equanimity. And equanimity means that whatever occurs around you or in the world or in the universe, or like we can now see so beautiful in the world with horrible things happening, whatever happens, you will stay equanimous, which means very quiet inside. You will watch it and see it occur, but it won't be a part of you. It just happens outside of you.
在你周围所发生的事情，不管是有多么美好，也不管有多么的难受或者是痛苦，
你都是能够保持的内在一颗平稳，一个好像你是观察者的心态在观察那所有的发生，事不关己，你是一个平静的这种心态，这叫什么？这种心可以说是
出离心。
出离心，
出离心，Now, what is a very interesting thing about it is that this equanimity sort of causes that all the things from outside don't touch you too deeply. You can see them, you can feel what's going on, you can realize what's going on, but it doesn't mean it has to become a part of you.
这个出离心很有意思的是你一旦有这个出离心，在你周围所发生的不管是什么事情，它就没有办法真正的碰触到你，是你只能够保持在这个核心里面，内在的那个核心的稳定智慧。
Sometimes people confuse it with being cold and harsh and not involved, but it actually means that because you're equanimous, you can fully see what's going on. You're not part of all the things that are happening. You realize that everything that happens outside of you is indeed the outside world. It's not you.
有时候人们会误解说啊，有出离心的人就好像很冷漠，好像事不关己。其实不然，真正的出离心呢，是你知道事情所有的发生都是在你的外面发生的，是这个世界发生的，而真正的你是没有改变，没有变化，它不会碰触到。
Now you've all come to this wonderful event. I don't know if you all have been here for the full 3 days, but you know, you've all come here and you always want to take something away, which is beautiful, right? You want to take something beautiful away. And the thing that we most want, all of us want this, that's funny to realize, all of us want this, and we want it in a different way maybe, but we all want the same thing, that's happiness. That's all we want.
在我们在场的应该是3天都有参加啊。那既然大家来到这里，我相信大家都是来的时候有渴望说，哎，你想要拿带走一些什么东西，而且我相信你想带走的是美好的东西，而这美好的东西里面最重要我相信是快乐。那很有趣的，我们每一个人都会想要美好的东西，带走快乐，但是呢，
Now to realize that you want to be happy means that every sentient being has that same wish in itself.
一旦你知道说，哎，你想要有快乐，你也必须要了解其他的存在的每一个人或者每一个生物，他们的内在都希望什么？快乐。
So it doesn't matter what kind of sentient being you are. You might be a person. You might be Chinese. You might be from Africa.You might be from Europe, it doesn't matter, we all want happiness, but a pig wants happiness, and a cow wants happiness, and a dog wants happiness. So every sentient being actually wants one thing, and happiness.
所以不管你是什么样的人，也许是中国人、非洲人，或者是甚至不管什么人，还甚至连猪或者是牛，任何有情的众生，他们都希望快乐。
Now that is actually a very deep realization. If you really realize that everything and everybody around you actually wants happiness.
如果你能够真正知道，就是所有的有情众生都渴望快乐，那这其实是一种很深刻的了解。
Because
因为
very funny.Ghosts want happiness. Ghosts, they want happiness. The gods, if they are up there or somewhere here, they want happiness. So everything that is energy is actually looking for a resolvement in happiness. That's what they're looking for. Now, where does the confusion in this life start? The confusion starts when you think that happiness is outside of yourself. So happiness is something that is actually already within you. It is in you. It's not without you, it's in you. But what do we see in the world today? We are all looking for happiness outside of ourselves. And it might even be that we think we find happiness in another person. But that person can never live up to your expectations. You have expectations that you want fulfilled, and that other person can never fulfill your happiness. The only one that can do that is you. So you are your own happiness, nothing else. Now the problem in this world, of course, is that we have unlearned, which is a funny word, we have unlearned how to find that happiness within ourselves. We used to be able to find that. When we were a baby, didn't matter. We were happy. So, that means that the happiness within you is something that you look for, and everything and everybody around you is looking for that happiness. So if you see around you that other people are losing their happiness, then suddenly within you there must arise this compassionate feeling where you are hoping and trying to resolve this problem for the other. There's two ways to do this. The one way is by just saying happiness is within you, go and find it within yourself, not without yourself. And the other way is to show how incredibly happy you are by just being. Because that works. People will look at it and say, hey, I want that too.
Bye.
this peaceful state that will occur when you find this happiness within yourself, that you realize, hey, I don't need any objects, I don't need a person to fulfill my happiness, but I can be happy within myself. This is a state that is constant. It's always there. But we, just as the people around us, get confused because we transform this happiness into something else. And it might be a person, and it might be a new car, and it might be a new bicycle, or the latest cell phone. I see lots of them here. The latest cell phone. Doesn't matter. Because it means from these objects you can realize that they are not happiness. They are not your happiness. And I always think, especially for men, that the beautiful, most beautiful example is a car, right? It's a new car, it smells new. No scratches on it. But we've all read the news where this guy comes out of the garage, he just bought the new car and smashes it immediately. So what he thought was happiness is actually the cause of his suffering. And I like to use the word dissatisfaction, because dissatisfaction actually translates much better than suffering. Suffering is so heavy. We already started to, oh, suffering, oh, terrible. No, it's dissatisfaction, unhappy about something. The cell phone that you just bought breaks down because they put a chip in it that after 1 year, when your guarantee is finished, it will break down. So the way to find this happiness is meditation. It's quite simple. But everything is meditation. Sitting here talking with you is meditation. Drinking your cup of tea is meditation. Painting is meditation. Doing the dishes is meditation. Everything is meditation. That means you can find happiness in every moment. You don't have to wait for happiness to occur. Okay, so we're going to do a meditation now. And I'm sure you've all heard about the chakras. I'm going to explain a little bit about the chakras. Many times when we see a chart of the chakras, they explain the chakras at the front of the body. But they're actually in the center of your body. So if you would stick a pin in here and take it down, then all these chakras are within your body. They're not on the front. You can see them give their energy out on the front, but they are within the body. Okay, the first chakra that we will use during this meditation, just to make sure that you 100% understand where we are, is the third eye. And if you press a little bit here, you will feel that it's a little bit painful. Well, that means you're on the right spot. The second one is the throat. And the throat is quite simple to recognize because there is a physical aspect. It's that lump in your throat that you sometimes feel when you swallow, when you do this, you feel that lump. That's exactly where that chakra is. Really well. And the next one is the heart chakra. Now press here. If you press here and you're on the right spot, you will feel it hurts a little bit. Just press. But again, it's within the body. It's not on the outside. Okay, and then there's the last one. Here is your navel. Two fingers above the navel is the solar plexus. Two fingers above the navel. And if you press here, you feel a little bit of pain. You don't feel it here. Feel it exactly here. Okay, that's the solar plexus. Again, inside the body. And the with the solar plexus, you can feel a little bit of a knot, N-O-T-T, a knot within the body. And this is the knot that you feel when you have to do something that you don't like. So you have to do something that you don't like, and then when you have to do it, like I give a speech and you don't like talking in front of a large group of people, you feel, somewhere, something going there. Well, that's that knot. And that's exactly the place where that solar plexus is. Now I have to explain one more thing before you're going to be in shock when I do it during meditation. I will say a little mantra, and I know you have been working with mantras as well, but this mantra is quite powerful. And what will happen is that you will feel an energy suddenly happening in the specific chakra where we are. Well, this is beautiful. Why does it work like that? Maybe nobody has explained that to you ever yet. The mantras actually work on three levels. First of all, they are usually set in Pali and Sanskrit. Pali and Sanskrit are two languages which are completely different from any language that we know now.
Okay. 这两种语言基本上跟我们现在的语言是完全不同的。
They are tonal, not in the sense of Chinese tonal going up and straight and down and whatever, but they are tonal in the sense that the word that you speak actually covers exactly what you're trying to describe. So, to give an example, in Pali there are never words like a telephone table, yeah, like combinations. Difficult. The word describes exactly what you're talking about.
这些字里面会就包含着这个要传递的这个东西的能量。
So it's sort of like one of the earliest languages, like at the start of the world, when we would look at each other and we would know what we mean, right?
这有点像人类历史的时代，我们看到人之间要表达的时候，我们只能说
See, I'm trying to make you say all sorts of things. Then secondly, the deep, touching, vibrational tone that you make. So the tone that you make is very important. If somebody says a Pali or a Sanskrit word, and blah, 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 which you sometimes hear the monks do, and I go like, no, 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 you got that wrong. It's boom, 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 so that it really hits and it really means something to you, so that something happens.
第二点，当你唱这些字的时候，这些巴利文或者是梵文的这些字，你需要很准确的去把那个节奏、把那个音调念出来，是能够深深的感动，而不能够就是小和尚念经的口气。
And then thirdly, they are deep universal truths. So it doesn't matter what your background is, or religion, or what your beliefs are. They are truths in the sense of the universe. Everybody that looks at them carefully will say, yeah, yeah I can see that. Yeah, I see that happening all the time. Yeah.
第三点，这个它本身就包含了真理在里面。它并不是关于任何宗教，任何信仰的。如果任何真正对这些精神或灵性的道理有所研究的话，你真的就会仔细的去观、去看、去研究，会了解说真的这些这是事实，在这些文字里面包含真理。
Okay, make sure that you got yourself a comfortable position. However you like to sit, I don't care about that. Just comfortable, how you feel. Fine. Remember, there is no good meditation, there is no bad meditation, there is only skillful and unskillful. So, whatever happens, whatever you do, it doesn't matter, it's always good. Don't judge yourself.
不要判断你自己，这没有所谓好的冥想和不好的冥想，只是需要在那里。然后呢，其实只能够说有些人是比较有经验，比较有技术，有些人比较没有技术，那没有关系，每一个经验都是好的经验。
好。Let the breath occur naturally. Don't interfere.
自然的发生，不用控制它，不要干扰。
Just watch it as it occurs. bring your concentration to a point in your nose where you can feel the airflow passing. Focus fully on that point. As you're sitting such, you try to remember what Metta, loving kindness, actually is.
那么这样坐着的时候,